About 2 years ago, I got that. And that was from GCHQ, marking the fact that I'd worked at Bletchley Park. I wore that today just to show that I'm proud of it. We wanted to win this war, and whatever we could do, or whatever we were able to do, we did. When I was told that I was going down to London, this was a new experience for me because I had never been out of Scotland up to that point. Only child, 19, and there I met up with other girls who were going to be going on to be trained for the same thing. When the bomb first appeared, it was manned, if you excuse the expression, by men. And they didn't think women could do it. But when they introduced women, they ended up with having nothing but women. I must say, the first time I saw the bomb, I was appalled. They had a height which you had to be or you couldn't work here, and I was under that height, as I later discovered. So they supplied me with a little wooden plank which went along the front of the bomb. You stand and look at the bomb, it's got these 108 drums. Now that is equivalent to 36 Enigmas. The Enigma was the enemy's encrypting machine, which was like a very heavy, old-fashioned typewriter. It had a choice of 3 rotors out of 5. It all had to be just found out which rotor it was that was being used and what was the starting letters. If I tell you that the Enigma machine was capable of 158 million, million, million possibilities, you can understand that it may have taken a little bit of time. But equally, these machines worked very fast. There were over 200 machines all working 24 hours a day. We worked for 8 hours, and then in the evening we'd go to one of the pubs in the village and have a few drinks, maybe meet some chaps there. You could sit at a table with a civilian and another service person or something, but you didn't talk about anything except perhaps, have you seen that film that's on this week, or what a rotten day this is, or something like that. You never, ever talked about what you were doing, even with people within the boundaries of Bletchley Park. I worked in Hut 11, and there were 5 machines there, 10 girls and 1 petty officer who was in charge of the telephone. We set it up according to the menu which was produced for us by Hut 6, and they had been able to find out 1 or 2 points about any signal. This is one drum, of which there are 108 on the machine. 4 little brushes behind every letter, and these connect with the commutator on the back and send the electricity around the system. You have to make sure that it clicks, and when it has, you turn it. One of us would set up the front of the machine, the other one would be plugging up the back of the machine according to the instructions on the menu. We'd set it off and it would start searching for possibilities. The indicator drums on the side, when they stop, these will have letters pointed out. And a 4th letter would be round the corner of the machine in a little slot. And these were the 4 possible settings for the rotor. If these letters were right, then they could read the signal off in clear German. When the war here finished, the girls were given screwdrivers and they just started to dismantle the machines. It must have been heartbreaking. We did do our best. We worked very hard. We worked very long hours for very, very little money. We weren't alone. A lot of people were doing that. It was a sign of the times. I mean, we were in a very bad state, and anything that we could do had to be done.